Hello friends, my name is Jimmy Singh. I'm broker owner of Supermax Realty. In this short video, we're going to discuss the new changes that are coming in regards to Ontario Residential Tenancy Act and what we call Bill 184. And the government is promoting this bill as, you know, Protection for Tenants and Strengthening Communities Act. So, you know, I've been hearing news for last couple of days. There's two sides of the story. The critics are saying, you know, they'll be it will lead to mass evictions in the province for the most vulnerable. So the people who can't speak English language, who are marginalized seniors or, you know, vulnerable people. And then, you know, the landlords, it will give landlord right to, you know, evict them and rent their properties at a higher value. So, and then also, you know, they said this is not the right time in pandemic that you're kicking people out, and you know, it might increase the infection rate, but when people are homeless. At the same token, the landlords feel that tenants, you know, till date has lot of say in landlord tribunal board, and this will basically make it level playing field and after years of disadvantage. But you know, at the same time, I don't see eviction will increase, you know, suddenly. My feeling is it will, you know, create a better opportunity for communication between the tenants and the landlords, you know, to discuss these things out of mediation or out of landlord-tenant board. So a little bit background. So as you know, most of the people are aware, in March, you know, the Ontario government put a ban on residential evictions, and right now the emergency declaration ends end of this month, probably July 24th. And technically landlords can start evicting the tenants as of August the 1st. But see friends, in last video, which I recorded a couple of months ago, I said practically the board is swamped. They're backlogged with so many, you know, eviction applications and those hearing matters. And there's backlog in some, you know, cities with 1 year, 1.5 year, 6 months. So chances are if you file your eviction application this year, your matter won't be heard in 2020. It will probably go to 2021. And certain landlords feel it's kind of a criminal thing that there are some people who take advantage of the system and then rent a house for 6 months, leave a big mess for the owners, and then go and scam somebody else. And then, you know, obviously for small landlords, it's a big thing because they want to get ahead in their life, buy investment property, and they have the bills of paying mortgages, you know, and insurance and taking care of the property. And some people do take, and they feel those people have to, you know, there has to be a criminal law to prosecute those people, right? That's the first thought. Second thing is, so what the changes they're doing is they're basically, government is not pressurizing, they're making out of court settlement. So what they're doing is they're saying landlords and tenants, why don't you guys work together, get a payment plan? So let's say if somebody lost a job in COVID and right now he owes landlord $15,000 in rent. So, you know, they want all the backlog to be taken care. The only option they see is if landlord and tenants start communicating and making a deal, you know, out the court. But still you have to understand, even they can have a written agreement, those agreements have to be reviewed by landlord-tenant board and need their consent or their blessing, right? So any contract you sign, you know, out of the board, you know, it's not like you can simply go ahead and that is legal contract. It has to be endorsed by an adjudicator, right? And then when the time happens, let's say if somebody promise you the payment plan and he stopped making those payments, then now the change says those tenants don't have an option to go back to landlord or tenant board, and the landlord can simply file an application of eviction, and the tenant will see a sheriff knocking at the door with the eviction notices, right? Second change is a lot of time some tenants you know, damage the properties, and then those claims or utility bills, unpaid utility bills, the landlord has to go through small claim court you know, to get those bills in his pocket. But the thing is that, you know, for the legal fee sometimes is too large for a small landlord to go through the court. But now with the new changes, the landlord has the right to go straight to the landlord tenant board to claim all these damages, unpaid utility bills, and they have 1 year to claim all these changes, right? So what Bill 184 is doing is it is increasing freedom to create landlord and tenant their own resolution before going in front of the board, right? So that's number one thing you have to remember. And obviously, you know, if you are a tenant, you will feel, you know, this is not the right time. You might lose a job, and then basically some big landlords like apartment building holders or, you know, multi-unit properties owners, you might be living in for last 5, 10, 15 years, and suddenly if they kick you out right now, rental market is crazy, and in a lot of cities the rents have doubled or tripled, right? So other thing they did in benefit of the tenant is the increase of fines. So right now under this bill, for an individual, the fines have increased from $25,000 up to $50,000, and for corporation, they have increased the fines from $100,000 to $250,000. And some critics feel, you know, this is just a slap on the hand for big, you know, landholders who have multiple buildings and, you know, apartment buildings, because they feel that, you know, they will use this law to kick, you know, tenants out, do renovation, increase the rent, and basically these penalties will be easily offset by their cash flow. So guys, this is an evolving situation. And as I said, you know, in last video as well, you know, right now government is taking care of a lot of people. There's Canada Emergency Response Benefit, which we call CERB, $2,000 check. And I think as a tenant, if you're getting the money, you can't hold the landlord, in a ransom. You can't simply, another change, you know, which is coming under Bill 184 is, let's say up till now, if a tenant takes landlord to the court and then basically says, you know, I don't want to pay, I'm not paying him bill because he's not taking care of my unit, or there's something broken, he has to fix it. And till date, these conversations can change suddenly, you know, from eviction. Suddenly the tenant can say, you know, he's not maintaining my house, and the adjudicator will basically take the side of tenants most of the times, and you know, put landlord on the hook. But another change which is coming right now under the bill provision is, unless the tenant mentions these things prior to the hearing, he can't bring on that date when this eviction process hearing, right? So let's say if you are a landlord and you took him to court for a, you know, eviction hearing, and you said he didn't paid my 4 months rent, at that particular time, if the tenant tried to bring these kind of excuses that, you know, my unit is not property maintained, or, you know, something is broken in my unit, they won't listen to these excuses. They'll just focus on one thing at hand, that is eviction. So the government actually, guys, is trying to, you know, fasten the process, cut the red tapeism, because there's a lot of frustration on part of tenants and landlords, especially the landlords, because they feel they are taking advantage by a lot of, you know, habitual people who just, you know, scammed, every 6 months go to a new landlord, don't pay rent after one or two payments, and then go scam somebody else. But as I said, not everybody can be painted with the same brush. And I was reading yesterday Federation of Rental Housing Providers of Ontario report. They said in May of this year, 93% tenants actually have paid the rent in full, 4% have paid rent in partial, and 3% haven't paid rent till now. So if we see June stats, they're pretty much in par. But what we have to see is, once those Canada government benefits dries up, those, you know, checks and all, you know, what will happen? Because there will be a lot of people who won't have an option and don't have money, don't have a jobs. And especially the marginalized people, seniors who can't speak English, or some people with disabilities who are living in an apartment building or a unit for last 10 years, and suddenly they will be out of housing, right? And that is another challenge. So guys, there is a changes coming, and obviously it's an evolving situation, and I'm sure even the new changes come, not everybody is happy. But I think there's, in this Bill 184, there's plenty of things for tenants' protection. At the same time, it gives a breather for the landlord, so they can also protect their investments. So if you have any comments on this, how do you feel about these changes, please feel welcome to leave your comments at the bottom of the video. And If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to share your comments, go ahead. My name is Jimmy Singh, 647-961-2639. And if you're a landlord facing a situation, you can give me a call to discuss, or visit my website, www.supermaxrealty.ca. Thanks for watching. Have a blessed day.